there, very good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and joining us today from Anglo Asian Mining, we have Reza Vaziri and Bill Morgan. A very good morning to you both. We've got so much to cover here today because, of course, we're talking about your 2021 full year results. We'll go through the highlights, the economics, and what's to come. But first of all, let's maybe kickstart this conversation with Reza. Maybe just give us an overview because plenty has been going on.
Good morning, Katie. Thanks for having us again. Let me start by saying that we had an extremely busy and difficult year in 2021. Difficult in a sense that we still had to deal with COVID's impact. Thank God that we had been able to manage it the best possible without any damage or loss of life for any of our employees during that period. And also, I have to mention that during that period, we never stopped operation. Operation was going on, but we delivered whatever we promised to the market. Also, in the other hand, it was extremely, and I can say most important year for the operation of Anglo-Asian Mining in few sense. Number one, we have been able to discover new deposit in Gedabek vicinity called Zafar. We extended our agreement with the government of Azerbaijan for 5 years, which by itself, it's not that significant news, but it's the best testament to demonstrate our relation, excellent relation with the government of Azerbaijan. The most important thing, we finally negotiated the agreement to acquire 3 new properties from the government of Azerbaijan. Successfully, we negotiated the PSA agreement to be modified to the old PSA we have, which has been signed in 1997. We successfully negotiated, finalized it, signed it. After that, all the coordinates about the properties that we are supposed to get was prepared, analyzed, approved, and signed. And the agreement has gone to the Cabinet of Ministers of Azerbaijan and President's Office to be sent to the Parliament for ratification. Also, we made our first investment out of Azerbaijan. As you know, we were looking for a long time to new properties out of Azerbaijan, and among those, finally, we find Libero Mining, Libero Copper, and we invested by purchasing 19.9% of the share of that company. And we are very happy about that investment, and we are very optimistic about the future of our investment in that company. Also, the Vejnali property, which has come back to us after the war has ended with Armenia, and Azerbaijan government gave us the access to Vejnali property. I personally went there to visit it. It looks like a good property. Our team is now working in Vejnali, and we are very hopeful that in the second half of this year, we can put Vejnali in production. I would like to talk a little bit about each of these items that I already talked about. Number one, development of Zafar mine. Zafar mine discovered in 2021 in vicinity of Gedabek. Maiden resource is published already with over 28,000 tons of copper and 73,000 ounces of gold. Portal will be opened and decline developed. Our team is working there. Our geology team, our topography team, and our construction team are working in Vejnali now. They are putting the canteen, camp, and rest of the laboratory and rest of the facility that we need for the operation in Vejnali. And as I said, we are all very hopeful that we can put Vejnali in production in second half of this year by producing about 4,000 tons of copper and 10,000 ounces of gold to compensate for the rest of the production we have from Gedabek area. Also, we will utilize our existing flotation plant to process whatever comes out of Zafar. And also, we are trying to modify a little bit with minimum of capital expenditure. Gedabek production sharing agreement, as I said, has been extended for another 5 years. As you know, we have after expiring these 5 years, we have another 5 years to extend in Gedabek. We are entitled to this under the PSA agreement. And I believe approving this 5 years extension immediately after our request should demonstrate our fantastic relation with the government of Azerbaijan. The most important thing that has happened last year, which hopefully will transform our company from being junior mining company to mid-tier mining company, is acquiring 3 new properties from the government of Azerbaijan. As I said, the agreement is signed. We are waiting for the ratification, which hopefully will happen by end of this month. That's what we are told. Also, I would like to elaborate a little bit more on this because most of our shareholders are a little bit concerned about the delay in ratification of this agreement. In order to understand the process, our first agreement, which has been signed in 1997, took 4 years. So it took 4 years to complete the negotiation, process of ratification, approval of the 7 ministry of the government of Azerbaijan. This is exactly the same process that we are taking now. As I said, contract is signed and has been sent to the president's office in order for issuance of decree and sending the contract to the parliament of Azerbaijan for ratification. There is no reason whatsoever that we believe this is not going to be ratified. We have full assurance from the government. This is a good contract, both for the benefit of the country and for us as well. This transaction, it's going to be transformational for our company. As you have heard before, after the ratification of this agreement, this new property will be under our portfolio with about 1 million, close to 1 million tons of copper. And this makes us the producer of copper and zinc in very near future, in next 2-3 years after we get this properties from the government of Azerbaijan. And you can imagine having that much copper under our belt definitely will transform this company from junior mining company to mid-tier mining company. I also would like to say a little bit more about our investment in Libero. Libero is a good company, undervalued based on its portfolio and portfolio of copper. We know that company. We made good study to participate to purchasing the share of that company. Our vice president, Mr. Farhang, visited recently the Macau and rest of the properties that Libero has. He came back extremely happy and impressed by all operation, all employee, geologists, and rest of the technical team, especially with the CEO, Mr. Slater, which has done fantastic job so far, and I'm sure he will continue doing that by bringing profit for both Libero and Anglo Asian mining. We have managed to achieve all this with remaining financially robust, and I have hand over to Bill to talk about the numbers and everything in more details. Bill?
Okay, well, good morning, Casey. I'll just give you a quick overview of the key numbers. Our turnover for the year was down 9% to 92.5 million. And the reason for this was that we produced significantly less gold, at 48.6 thousand ounces compared to 56.8 thousand ounces last year. And this was due to the fact that we were mining lower gold grade ore as our existing mines at Gedabek are coming to the end of their lives. However, copper production did increase from 2,591 tons to 2,649 tons. Our turnover was helped during the year by increased metal prices. The gold price was virtually flat, but the average price of copper increased significantly from $6,190 dollars per ton to $9,294 per ton. Our profit before tax decreased from $35 million to $13 million due to higher cost of sales, These were 74 million compared to 60 million. And there were two main reasons for this increase in our cost of sales. Our all-in sustaining cost increased from $702 to $843 per ounce. Like many companies in this industry, we experienced significant cost inflation, especially in regard to diesel fuel and reagents. And obviously, because our ore was lower grade, we were having to do more processing to get the equivalent amount of gold out. We also produced more of our gold in the form of concentrate as opposed to gold doré, and this further impacted our profitability. This year, we produced 2,475 ounces of gold as opposed to 2,154 ounces last year. We sell our concentrate to metal traders and only receive around 75% of the value of the gold, as transport and smelting costs are much higher for concentrate. So obviously, as we produce more gold as concentrate, that's not so profitable for us. The lower turnover and higher cost of sales were reflected in our profit after tax, which was 7 million compared to 23 million last year. Cash generation was down really in step with the lower profitability, with free cash flow at 15 million compared to 29 million. This free cash flow effectively financed our dividend payments of 11 million last year and the investment in Librero of 2 million. So that's really the headline numbers. The company balance sheet remains strong. Our cash only decreased by less than 2 million in the year to 37 million, despite the dividend payments, and we still have no bank debt. As well as our own cash resources, we have ample sources of finance, including an existing 15 million bank loan, and we also may be putting in place a commercial paper program, which could also raise significant debt finance if we require the capital. And obviously, the part that all of our shareholders are mostly interested in is our dividend. We'll be paying a final dividend for the year, 3.5 cents, and this will maintain the dividend at 8 cents for the year. This is the same compared to last year, if you take out the special dividend of 1.5 cents we paid last year. And we believe that it is prudent to pay this dividend despite the fall in profitability, you know, given the company's strong balance sheet.
All right, then. Should we maybe conclude with Reza today and just give us a conclusion as to what we've got to look forward to?
Sure. Katie, we are in much better shape this year than any previous year because of the situation in Azerbaijan. COVID problem now settled. Thank God that had minimum effect in our whole operation and people. The war between Ukraine and Russia so far had no effect, and I don't anticipate any negative effect in our operation. This year, Anglo Asian Mining is now a very different company from this time last year. We are transitioning to become a much bigger copper miner in next few years, and we'll start producing zinc as well next year, hopefully. We have commenced in-depth exercise to evaluate our sustainability reporting and practice. We will be including for the first time in company's history, the ESG report in our annual report this year. And we're going to continue evaluating ESG progress in our company for the years to come. In the interim period, until we bring new mines such as Zafer into production in Gedabek area, we are actively trying to find production from other sources we have, such as Gosha. We have find new vein type of zone in Gosha area, which is called Hassan. We are very hopeful to start production from that part of Gosha in second half of this year. And also production from Vejnali. We are studying to see if everything at the beginning is gonna be trucked out to Gedabek, or we're gonna process in the Vejnali's processing plant itself, which needs a bit of modification with minimum capital cost. Hopefully very soon we will find out either we do it in the Vejnali itself, process in Vejnali itself, or we'll track it out to Gedabek to be processed. Libero is starting to show some excellent result after the first drill in Macau, and we are very happy about it and excited about it. Also, I would like to say 8 years ago, Anglo-Asian transitioned successfully from being a simple producer of gold by only one heap leach system and surface mine in Gedabek. Now we are more we have much more complex operation by building our flotation plant, our agitation plant, and starting underground mining. We believe we are now at the similar point in the company's development and growth trajectory. So all I have given you, Katie, was a good news, and I don't anticipate anything other than that.
All right. Well, thank you both very much indeed for that in-depth interview with you. That's Reza Vaziri there and Bill Morgan discussing your 2021 full year results, going through the balance sheet as well and telling us what is to come from Anglo Asian Mining here on Proactive this morning.
Thank you, Katie.
Okay, thank you, Kate.
We'll be right back.